My name is Patrick Gatzke and I'm a PhD candidate at the Faculty of Law and Administration at Warsaw University, where I conduct a research project concerning the status of victims in international criminal law under the supervision of Professor Karol Karski. My research is funded by the Minister of Science and Higher Education as part of the Diamond Grant Program. I am also a recipient of the ETUDA scholarship from the National Science Center in Poland. In my work, I follow an institutional development of international criminal law. I do so by identifying three phases. The first phase, just after the Second World War, when the Nuremberg and Tokyo tribunals were established. The second phase, with two ad hoc tribunals set up in the mid-1990s, following tragic events in the former Yugoslavia and Rwanda. And finally, the third phase, which began together with the creation of the first permanent international criminal court, the International Criminal Court in The Hague, which became operational in 2000s. I mentioned these tribunals deliberately because part of my analysis is concerned with the procedural standing of victims of international crimes. In this respect, I think it is crucial to remember that international criminal tribunals are not identical. In fact, there are many differences between them. To give you just one example, these tribunals have dealt with victims of international crimes in diverse ways. This means that victims' empowerment will, of course, differ depending on which tribunal is being examined by us. In Nuremberg and Tokyo trials, for instance, victims could only act as witnesses, which means that their engagement with international criminal justice was fairly limited. This claim becomes even more visible and convincing when one studies testimonies of relatively few victim witnesses who had a chance to appear before the Nuremberg tribunals. Two of them were actually Polish citizens, Seweryna Szmaglewska, a well-known writer, and Samuel Reitzman. They both provided information to the tribunal about the organized killings and other forms of victimization in concentration camps in Auschwitz and Treblinka. Let me also say that Szmaglewska's testimony about the inhuman and degrading treatment of women and children in Auschwitz left a particularly strong impression on people who were present in a courtroom, as it has been noted in numerous post-trial publications. Over the past 75 years since the Nuremberg and Tokyo trials, the status of victims in international criminal law has markedly changed. This conclusion stems from the fact that in the currently existing ICC system, victims possess a much stronger procedural position as compared to previous international criminal courts and tribunals. Apart from their role as witnesses, victims may also directly participate in ICC proceedings and to claim reparations for the suffered harm. This means that victims are currently more present as subjects of international criminal law than ever before.